So we are going to be looking at elimination method in solving linear equation with two variables. So in our previous class, we saw the substitution method to solve this linear equation with two variables. So we are going to use this question to explain this elimination method. This is the same question we use for the substitution method. Okay. So now what we are going to do for the elimination method, for the word elimination means removing, okay, or canceling out. So we are going to look for a way to cancel out one of these variables so that it will be simplified in the way that we can get the other variable. Now what we are going to do is this. We look at equation 2. If we multiply 2 with on the equation 2, we are going to have that a new equation will be 2x plus 2y is equal to 4. That is our new equation of 3. Okay, so what we did here is that we multiply everything here with what? With 2. Okay, so it affects the right hand side and the left hand side. So we have this equation now. Now the other equation we have here is equation 1. You see that the point is that the equation 1 have 2x and equation 3 also have 2x. So with that method of multiplication. So we have not changed anything in equation 2 because we did it from both sides. So we balance it with the equation. So now what we are going to do is to subtract equation 1 with what? With equation 3. So that what we are going to have is that equation 1 is 2x plus 5y equal to 10. And equation 3 is equal to 2x plus 2y equal to 4. So when we subtract, we are going to see that 2x minus 2x is equal to 0. Okay. Now 5y minus, because we have the minus here, affects everything. 5y minus 2y is equal to what? 3y. Okay. Then this will be 10 minus 4, which is equal to what? 6. So you see now that this implies that our 3y is equal to 6. So if we divide both sides by 3, we are going to see that our y will be equal to 6 all around 3, which is equal to 2. So we have that our y is equal to 2. Okay, so that's the same question which results from the substitution method. So now we can now substitute. Okay, that since in equation 2, from our equation 2, we have that x plus y is equal to 2, so that when we substitute, everywhere we see y will go to, that x will be equal to this, which is equal to 2, so that we have that our x is equal to 0. So therefore, we have that y is 2, okay, and also our x is what is 0. Which is what? Correct. So that's the elimination method. So you see, we try to eliminate one of the variables here from the elimination method. And this is a good answer we got from the substitution method. Okay, so we'll stop here for today. So see you in our next class. Thank you very much.